He supports me. So if you can support me as your wife when I'm seeing my menstruation, you should be able to support this country when you're leaving them. Especially young girls when they're in school. How do we make these girls feel safe and be clean when they see their menstruation? They have the right hygiene, they have the right product when they're in school, so they don't miss out the class. If you give up free quality education, and then you have 50% of your population don't come to school because of menstruation, where is the equality in it? So that's the reason why we try to introduce the free sanitary pads, so that every girl will have the opportunity to be in school, remain in school, so they don't have any excuse why they are not in school. Today, from 39% of girls who will end the year in school, is now 89%.
Wow. Congratulations.
We have more girls in school today. We have girls in all public exams. It's the girls that top every public exam in this country today. Which means we are not mistaken. His Excellency knows exactly what he needed to do. So we are now challenging the girls, like, you know, it's not only about finishing your secondary school, but go to university, and not just go to university and do any random subject. The president has now offered all young girls doing STEM subjects, engineering, medicine, everything. The government will pay for you until you finish your studies. So, you know, giving them that space also for them to grow and let them also do things that are more challenging, that you feel that women are not supposed to be doing this. Now we can give them that space and opportunity. So I'm humbled that you came in today without even resting. You decided to come to this office. I'm very much humbled. The work that I do, I don't do it for attention. I do it to have a genuine change. And I don't just do it for a change for Sierra Leone, but I want it to be a change for every woman, because every woman around the world deserves it. Every woman around the world deserves to be safe. Every woman around the world deserves to be comfortable. They need to have their own rights to choose who they want to marry, who they want to date. Every woman should have that freedom to make that decision for themselves. And when we stand at the front and we see a man standing next to us, it gives us more confidence to do it. So please keep doing what you do, because believe you me, you might not have a lot of people that might say to you, bravo, someone like me who's been a victim and I understand what abuse is all about. I appreciate you.
Thank you very much.
So I want to say thank you to every one of you. And I hope that your stay in Sierra Leone will be fantastic. Before you go and explain more about Sierra Leone, you have to eat cassava.
Okay,
right. So ask the hotel to prepare your cassava. If their cassava leaf is not nice, let me know. I'll cook you the best cassava leaf, because it's only when you eat cassava leaf, then you are from Sierra Leone. What you're explaining that it took you 20 hours to be here. I mean, our country is the most unique country in the world. For you to come here, you have to use all mode of transportation.
I love it. And by the way, you just said go to the hotel and have cassava leaf, or have the first lady cook cassava leaf. I mean, that's a pretty easy option right there.
But I want to welcome you, and I look forward to, I know CARE also supported the UN resolution for the World Day. It's a big deal for me, and knowing full well that an organization like CARE will put their own pen on that and say, we support this. You are not doing it for a first lady, but you are doing it to save the world. We have a lot of survivors, because I'm saying that when you've been abused as a child does not make you a victim for the rest of your lives. There come a time when you become a survivor, have to survive in the right way. And that's the reason why I was able to champion November 18th as a world day, so that you give them that day to just come out and know that they are not alone in this fight, and they are not not the only one who is being called victims. And from that point, you now stop to see yourself as a victim, but see yourself as a survivor, because you're not alone in it. So I want to thank you also, and if you can extend that to your head in New York and say, I truly do appreciate that they actually helped with supporting the November 18th resolution at the United Nations. I'm very grateful that we had the day. I'm now looking forward to joining the Lazzarotti Committee in Europe, so that again we continue to amplify the need for us, the world, to protect our children.
My mission has always been about getting men on board. Right? I'm actually starting a men's group and union in the US of leaders who are specifically to get behind female forces, women, or empowerment. Bizarrely enough, that hasn't happened yet. Right? You know, so it's actually the UN that have asked me to do this. And this is a piece of it. Working with organizations like CARE that make a huge impact around the world, who simply care about people. And for me, that's where it starts. It starts with the fact that, you know, we should all be treated equally. And I don't understand why men are so scared of giving women equal opportunity. It's like starting a race and saying that we're going to start 10 feet in front of you. Yeah, and then we're going to start the race. And when we win that race, we're going to pat ourselves on the back because we beat you in the race. But guys, that's not how it works, right? And it's so obvious when you look at it, and certainly when I have my own children, my own daughter, you know, in the US or in the UK, being treated differently than my son in the US and the UK, and watching what's happening around the world, this is not an issue that's African, this is not an issue that's Indian or Asian, or it's a world issue, and it's in every echelon of society, and it requires, to your point, us coming together. It's all of us. It's not a UN women. It is a UN problem. It is a world problem. And it takes men like everyone around this table to stand up and man up and say, to really be a man is to be a human, and that is to stand up for everybody, everyone in humanity, together. And, you know, so for me to be able to come to a place like this, this incredible country of yours, interview women who are really making a difference, and hear from their perspective on a local level, but also on a global level. Because what you're saying resonates. Every single thing that you said to me just now is no different than the exact same problems that we suffer from in the United States. And I think that is a big part of it, because people like to think that, oh no, it's different. You know, and they talk about sort of, you know, sub-Saharan Africa for this, and this for that, and everything else. And I'm like, no guys.
Abuse is abuse.
Exactly. It's the same thing. It doesn't matter. It hurts as much. You know, the scar is the same. You know, and it requires the same level of love. And we're only hurting ourselves. And so this is the only answer. And unless you speak up, and I know that you do, but unless people hear, and that's for me as a storyteller through photography and through filmmaking, that is my art form. That's my way of delivering messages. So wherever I go, I bring my team, and we're not small, to try and capture the narrative, to help amplify, and that's it. You know. So my ask of you is that if you have time, whether it's today, whether it's later on in the week, or whatever it is, that we are able to talk to you and you know, and have some way of getting your incredible message out, so I can share it with the world at some level.
With every problem that a woman faces today.
Yeah, I'd love to just talk about that, to be honest. I mean, that is enough, because that's the reason why we came. When we heard of Polanyi, I heard, they already knew. We were looking at the various different countries, you know, that we wanted to come to.